RGB lighting has a problem, and even people who work with them may not even know it yet. LEDs use RGB technology, and to get different colors, you use a combination of red, green, and blue. Remember what you learned in grade one? In 2023, we use LEDs for almost all of our virtual production workflows. But the problem occurs with skin tones and when an actor is lit by LED or acting on an LED wall. Typically, skin tones are picked up with more of a warmer hue on LED, leaving it red or even magenta. So, how do we fix it? Enter Brompton Technology, who don't actually make LED panels. They make processors for LED panels. And their solution for the RGB problem is what they're calling TrueLight. TrueLight uses X-ray emitters to expand the range of colors on RGB. Mind blowing? I know. So we flew down to Florida to catch up with Brompton at Infocomm 2023 and get the inside scoop on how TrueLight is gonna change the game in virtual production lighting.
This is Brompton's setup and they've got their screens and then they've got their final display up there. I think that I'm actually gonna hop in with Caesar and he's gonna kind of walk me through TrueLight and what it changes. So I actually haven't looked at TrueLight at all intentionally for this moment. Apparently it's really gonna change the way that you think about color science, the way that you think about skin tones. So I haven't done any research prior to this. Caesar's gonna walk me through everything.
Then Caesar put me in a booth full of LEDs that lit me with what I thought was a neutral overcast scene. But when activating TrueLight, it was amazing to see how off my skin tones were before flipping to the correct color calibration. And then Caesar made a great point. While most people won't realize the red hue, experts will notice that the light color is wrong. Your eyes automatically adjust to the red hue, but that's not the true color, the true light, if you will.
That first demonstration was actually crazy. You don't notice how red your skin tones are until you're just sitting in here. This is kind of wild.
Trying to solve all this in post-production will be a lot of work because it's only in the foreground element.
I think about the times that we've had to color correct what we've shot on LED, and it's so tough. Like, skin tones turn very pink or very red whenever you try to add anything to the curve.
Now, the only thing I see, everybody looks red, right? And this is what we need to change.
So, I guess the question is, does it work?
Now, I'm no color scientist, but I think that can play to our advantage here. I'm not looking for those subtle percentile differences in hue shift, and my untrained eye can see a dramatic difference
between LED in the standard RGB spectrum to LED with TrueLight activated.
Now let me be clear, there's only 16 tiles in the world that are able to be manipulated by TrueLight at this time.
Correction, since we started filming this video, TrueLight is now available for purchase. There's definitely more than 16 tiles available in the world. Check it out. Back to the video.
And it was an absolute privilege to be walked through how RGBW and TrueLight are gonna change the game in color science for virtual production.
And if you're interested in a deeper dive on TrueLight, Brompton CEO Richard Mead has a full paper on their website that I've linked in the description of this video.
That's it, actually.
Anything else?
So, until next time, see you later.